Hi students, from now onwards we will study about the very important topics of arithmetic. The very first chapter that we shall study now is averages. Average helps us to understand the behavior of a group of data. It somehow gives us an overall idea of a group of data in terms of one numeric value. It could be the average rainfall experienced by the country in a particular month, or it could be your average savings, or it could even be the average runs scored per inning by any particular cricketer in his entire batting career. So, here we will study about the different types of averages like mean, mode and median, how to calculate them and see their applications. Further, we will study about the concept of weighted mean. In order to understand these concepts more clearly, we will solve a few problems based on them. So, let's begin this lecture, which is all based on the concept of averages. First of all, we have to understand what do we mean by averages and why do we have to study about them? What are the applications of averages, or what exactly do we understand by the term averages? So, let's first see what do we mean by an average. An average is a measure that tells us information about a group of things rather than the data about the individuals. So, if we say that we have a group of data, then average is something that tells us the information about this group of things. So average directly denotes a particular feature of all these data instead of telling about the individual data. So actually we can say that average is a value that gives an indication about a group of data instead of telling about the individual data. Now there are many ways to measure the information about a group of data. So averages could be the arithmetic mean, could be the median, could be the mode, could be a geometric mean or even a harmonic mean. But for most part of this lecture, we are going to confine our studies to the study of arithmetic mean. So most of the time, we are going to use the word average to indicate arithmetic mean. Now let us say that we have a table that gives us an indication of the amount of rainfall that occurred throughout the week. On Monday, it was 5.5 centimeters. Tuesday, it was 4.6 centimeters. Wednesday, it was 5.8 centimeters. Thursday it was 6.3 centimeters, Friday it was 6.9 centimeters, Saturday it was 7.1 centimeters and Sunday it was 5.7 centimeters. Now let's try to plot this in a graph and we get this kind of a graph. So it represents the amount of rainfall in these particular days of a week. Now if I say, what is the average rainfall for the entire week? So what is the mean rainfall for the entire week? Now how are you going to find that out? Now we know the individual rainfall that occurred in a particular day. For example, we have the data for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. But now what is the mean rainfall for this entire week? What is one particular data that tells us or gives an indication about the rainfall that occurred for this entire week? Now how to calculate the mean rainfall for this entire week? Let's take one more example. Let us say that we have a class. Now, the age of the teacher is given by 27 years, the age of this student is given by 11 years, the age of this student is 10 years and the age of this student is 11 years. So now we have the ages for different members of this class. Now what is the average age of this class? Now if I ask you what's the average or the mean age of this class, then how are you going to find that? Let's take one more example. All of us are given pocket money by our parents. Now we spend most of the part of it, but at the same time, some amount of it is saved by us. This gives us a table of our savings for the entire year. On January, we saved 100 rupees. On February, our savings was 60 rupees. In the month of March, it went to 75. In April, it was 110 rupees. In May, it was 120 rupees. In June, it was 90 rupees. In July, it was 100 rupees. August, it was 130. September, it was 120. October, 140. November, it was 125. And for the month of December, it was 115. Now, what is the average or the mean savings per month for the entire year? So, what was the average savings per month for the entire year? Now, how are you going to calculate that? Now to answer all these questions, let's try to look at the formula for finding the average of a group of data. Now let us say that we have got n elements of a group. So there are n elements x1, x2, x3, x4, and so on up to xn. Now, the formula to calculate the mean of this data is given by average or the mean equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 and so on up to xn divided by n. Your x1 plus x2 plus x3 and so on up to xn is actually the sum of all these data, and n is the number of such elements. So average is given by the sum of all the entries divided by the number of entries. It's come to the very first question, that is finding the average rainfall for the entire week. So these represent the amount of rainfall that occurred in the respective days. Now average is given by sum of all the entries divided by the total number of entries. So we add all these numbers: 5.5 plus 4.6 plus 5.8 plus 6.3 plus 6.9 plus 7.1 plus 5.7, and the total number of days are 7. So we divide it by 7. What do we get? The average comes out to be equal to 5.99 approximately. So we can say that the average or the mean rainfall for the entire week comes out to be equal to 5.99 approximately. Let's go back to the second problem, that is finding the average age of this class. What we do is, again, the average age of the class would be 27 plus 10 plus 11 plus 11 divided by 4, as 27, 11, 10 and 11 are the respective ages of all these members, and there are actually 4 members in the class. So we divide it by 4. What we get? We get 14.75 as the average age of this class. So using the formula for mean, we have calculated the answer. Again, let's find out the average savings for the entire year. So these are the savings for January, February, March and so on up to December. We simply use the formula, that is average is equal to sum of all the entries divided by the total number of entries. So 100 plus 60 plus 75 plus 110 plus 120 plus 90 plus 100 plus 30 plus 120 plus 140 plus 125 plus 115. So what we do is, we add all these savings and divide it by 12, as well as the number of months in a particular year. So what we get? We get the average as 107.084. So the average or the mean amount of savings is equal to 107.084 per month in this particular year. So what exactly average denotes? If we save 107.084 per month, then that would be the same as this type of saving. So this particular value is an indication of the amount of savings that occurred throughout these months. Now let's see an example to understand how useful averages are, or how accurate information do they give about the data which they represent. Suppose that in the interview, the owner tells that the company has got 10 employees and each of them earns an average salary of rupees 2000 per day. So this is the information given to you. But the truth is, the owner earns 11,000 per day and the other employees earn 1,000. If you try to calculate the average of all these salaries, then what we get is average equal to 11,000 plus 9 into 1,000, as the other 9 employees get a salary of 1,000 per day. And the total number of employees is equal to 10. So we divide this by 10. What we get? Average equal to 2,000. So the owner is telling us the truth, that the average salary is rupees 2,000 per day. But now the big question is your salary going to be 2,000 rupees per day? Because we have seen the other employees earn a salary of just 1,000, not 2,000. But when we calculate the average, we get the value as equal to 2,000, which means that if we consider the average, then our salary should be 2,000. But in reality, the salary would be 1,000 rupees. So you cannot take average to be a value that represents the entire data. The individual data can very much differ from the average. So arithmetic mean is an overall indicator, not the absolute indicator. But now in this case, if the average doesn't tell us the true nature of the data, then there must be some indicator showing that. So for that, let's look at the second type of average, which is the median. And what is median? The median is the number in the middle when the numbers are listed in order. So whenever we list all the numbers of a group in an increasing order, the middle value is known as the median. So the median gives us the middle value of any group of data. Let us see that we have the numbers 6, 4, 67, 23, 6, 98, 8, 16 and 37. So this is a group of data. Now, if we arrange all these numbers in an increasing order, then they could be arranged as 4, 6, 6, 8, 16, 23, 37, 67, and 98. Now, if you look at this string of data, then we see that there are 9 entries. So, the middle value would be the 5th element, and the 5th element is 16. So, 16 represents the middle value of this group of data. And so, the median of this particular data would be 16. So 16, which is the middle value when arranged in an increasing order, is the median of this particular data. This is the way we calculate the median of a group of data. Now, what about when there is an even number of numbers? We have earlier taken the case when the number of numbers is odd, when 9 numbers are such. So the middle value is very easy to calculate, which is the 5th one. But when we have got even numbers, then there are 2 middle numbers. Now, how to calculate the median in such a case? Let's take an example. The numbers are 6, 10, 12, 8, 20, and 16. Now, again, the first step would be we are going to arrange these numbers in an increasing order. So, arranging them in an increasing order, we get 6, 8, 10, 12, 16, and 20. Now, we see that we have got 2 middle numbers as such, 10 and 12. But we have to find out one particular value for the median. So what we do is, median in this case would be equal to the mean of 10 and 12. So we take the mean of these two middle values. So 10 plus 12 divided by 2 would be equal to 11. And so the median of this particular group of data would be 11. So in case of even numbers, there are 2 middle numbers. And what we do is, take out the average of these two middle numbers to get the median of any group of data. Now again, coming back to the previous example. Looking at the salaries again, to find the median salary, we look at the salaries in order. So we have seen that 9 employees earn a salary of 1000 rupees per day and the owner earns a salary of 11,000. So when we arrange these salaries in an increasing order, we get this as a particular arrangement. Now this is an even number of salaries. So we look at the middle two. The middle two both are 1000. So 1000 plus 1000 divided by 2 would again be equal to 1000. And so, the median of this is 1000, and that's the amount of salary that you would get if you accept the job. So in this particular case, we see that the median is a more effective tool of representing a group of data as compared to the mean.